is growing criticism involving the state-run Holyoke Soldiers Home, where dozens of veterans died from coronavirus. The group, Disabled American Veterans of Massachusetts, told the I-Team that it has no confidence in the state's veteran services or in its secretary. Francisco Urena has not been seen in public since the crisis began. WBZ Chief Investigator Cheryl Piandaka went looking for answers and for the secretary himself.
I'm just sad. I just wish that we could have had a better goodbye with him.
All Michelle Roseo has now are the memories of the grandfather who helped to raise her. At 96, Francis Roseo, who everyone called Mike, was living at the soldiers' home in Holyoke. He died last month after contracting COVID-19.
I don't think we've received an apology for this. And unfortunately, I don't even really think the administration thinks that they did anything wrong.
And families aren't the only ones who say they are frustrated by the lack of compassion and leadership by the Secretary of Veterans Affairs, Francisco Urena.
The buck stops with him. He's responsible for both soldiers' homes. Chelsea Soldiers Home and Holyoke Soldiers Home.
In March, the Massachusetts chapter of the Disabled American Veterans sent a letter to the governor demanding change, claiming the Department of Veterans Affairs was nowhere to be found during the Soldiers Home crisis, and veterans were left to die. Days later, the governor placed Bennett Walsh, the administrator in Holyoke, on administrative leave, but Urena remains on the job.
There are, what, over 100 deaths now between the two soldiers' homes? That's something he's going to have to live with.
Urena has not been at any of the governor's news conferences, and veterans organizations say he has not visited the Chelsea or Holyoke homes. The I-Team made several attempts to reach the secretary at his office, on social media, and even sent him a text on his cell phone, where we received a reply that we have been blocked. Without answers from the Secretary of Veterans Affairs, families who lost loved ones say they are struggling to make peace with the tragedy.
I take comfort in the fact that he's with my grandma now, and that's where he wants to be. I know he's watching over me, and he's going to be my angel for the rest of my life.
A spokesperson for Urena told us today that the number we were blocked from was not his, despite records indicating it is. And when asked, failed to provide another number to contact him. We were also told the secretary was unavailable for an interview. Cheryl Fiandaka, WBZ News.